Dissection of a toad or a frog. A toad or a frog is one of the animals whose anatomy, physiology, ecology are studied for USE biology exams. The other animals include a rat, a cockroach that will be found on different CDs. Note that the anatomy, physiology, and the ecology of the two animals is very similar. That for examination purpose, a toad and a frog can be used interchangeably. Classification, kingdom, animalia. Justification 1. A frog or a toad is multicellular. This distinguishes them from protista that are composed of mainly unicellular animals, such as amoeba. 2. A frog or a toad has a mouth for heterotrophic nutrition. This distinguishes it from plants that make their own food. 3. A frog or a toad has got limbs for locomotion. This distinguishes it from fungi. Fungi are heterotrophic organisms. They are multicellular, but fungi don't move from one place to another. Phylum, chordata. Justification. A toad is bilaterally symmetrical. That is, it can be cut into a half only once. 2. A frog has got a brain case or a skull where we have the brain. 3. A toad has got a backbone that can be felt when we touch the dorsal side of the toad. Kiras, amphibia. Justification, it has got a moist skin that lacks scales. 2. It has got external eardrum. 3. It has got a nictitating membrane. 4. It has got a wide gap, that is, its mouth moves from this side to this side. Order, anora. Justification. It has got a long and prominent hind limbs. It lacks a tail. Habitat. A toad and a frog stay in damp places near water bodies. They lay their eggs in water. The toad and frog use water for external fertilization. Feeding. A toad or a frog feeds on worms, insects, and grass. External features. Before we describe external features and their location, let us start with terms used to describe the topography of the animal. Dorsal, back side, ventral, front side, anterior, head side, posterior, hind side, lateral, on the sides. The head. The head is triangular, tapering anteriorly. This gives a toad a streamlined shape, reducing friction during movement. The head is dorsoventrally flattened. This enables a toad to easily crawl under the stone where it hides away from predators. Dimension is overhead. In exams, you may be required to measure the dimension is overhead. Note that the ruler measures to one decimal place in centimeters and not decimal place in millimeters. If required to measure in meters, then first measure in centimeters and convert the reading to meters by dividing by 100. Thickness. Measure the thickness using a divider like this. From the ruler, the thickness is 1.3 centimeters. Centimeters is written as small c, small m. The width. Measure the width like this. From the ruler is 2.6. The length of the head. It is measured like this. From the ruler, the length of the head is 1.8 centimeters. It is to be noted that the length and width of the head of a toad or a frog are approximately twice the thickness. The eyes, structure and location. The eyes are oval, large, protruding, dorsolaterally located to give the animal a wide field of view. The eyes are covered by an ictitating membrane that secretes fluids which lubricate and protect the eye. The nostril. There are two oval holes, those anteriorly located on the head. The location allows the frog to be submerged and leave the nostrils out of water for gaseous exchange. It is to be noted that during the breeding season, the toad requires a lot of energy and therefore oxygen that may be got from the air. The air is richer in oxygen than water. The ear. The ear is a circular patch of eardrum or tympanic membrane laterally located on the head. Function: to collect sound waves. Adaptation of the eardrum to its function is: the eardrum is large and externally located to increase sensitivity to sound waves. Note that lack of pinna gives a frog or a toad a streamlined body to reduce friction during movement in water. The limbs. Sometimes you are required to draw the hind and forelimb to the same magnification. Note that at the same magnification, the hind limb is longer, has a muscular thigh, two prominent joints, and five digits, whereas the forelimb is short, stout, has one prominent joint, and four digits. The hind limb has goat webs, whereas the forelimb lacks webs. A drawing of the hind and the forelimb to the same magnification. Note that the hind limb is long, has a muscular thigh, two prominent joints, five digits, and webs. The forelimb is short, stout, has one prominent joint, and four digits. Adaptive feature of the forelimb. 1. They are stout and short. They are jointed to absorb shock on landing. 2. They are attached to the front part of the body trunk to provide support of the body off the ground when at rest. adaptive features of the hind limbs that enable the specimen to survive in its ecology. 1. The limbs have massive thighs to generate repulsive force during hopping or swimming. 2. Hind limbs have two prominent joints to increase flexibility during hopping or swimming. The hind limbs have got webbed digits to generate repulsive force during swimming. The hind limbs are long to increase flexibility during hopping. Comparison of the hind limbs of a toad and that of a grasshopper in the view of evolution. They are both long, muscular, and used for hopping. Such organisms that have different ancestral origin but modified to perform the same function are termed as analogous structures. The type of evolution is called convergent evolution. The skin. The skin is thin, multicolored or mottled dorsally, and white or gray ventrally. Adaptation of the skin to its function. 1. It is thin to facilitate gaseous exchange. It's dark and multicolored dorsally to camouflage from aerial predators. 3. It is white ventrally to camouflage from aquatic predators. 4. The skin is tough to protect inner parts of the body. 5. It is moist to dissolve gases for easy gaseous exchange. Some of the questions that may arise from what we have just discussed may be: 1. Classify the specimen under the following taxa: 1. Phylum. 2. Class. B. Give reasons to justify the choices of the taxa in A above. 3. You may be required to measure proportions of the head. 4. You may be required to describe the structure and adaptation of the following parts, that is, eyes, skin, limbs, or any other parts. Adaptation is of the toad to its ecology, or features that allow a toad to live a successful life. Anything that allow a toad to live a successful life can be given as its adaptation to its ecology. 1. It has got eyes to see food. It has got limbs for locomotion. It has got eardrum to collect sound waves. It has a streamlined body for easy movement in the water. It has moist skin for gaseous exchange. It has a thin skin to facilitate gaseous exchange. It has webs to generate repulsive force for swimming. It has dark multicolored skin to camouflage from aerial predator. Internal structures. Before we dissect, note that the toad is dissected upside down. In this position, its left is our right, our left is its right. However, the question usually specify whose side is meant in the question, whether yours or a toad's. 2, make sure you understand the question before you answer, because any answer that does not answer the question does not carry any mark. We are going to dissect a frog according to common examination questions. This will give us an idea how the questions are likely to be. Question 1. Place the frog ventral side uppermost and dissect to remove the skin. A. Describe the attachment of the skin to the body wall. Procedure. Pin up the frog ventral side uppermost. Pin through each hand and foot. This should be at an angle to the strain put on it. Lift the skin of the abdomen with a forceps and with a scissor make a slit, then cut along the mid-ventral line to the level of the lower jaw. Observation. The skin is loosely attached to the ventral side of the abdominal wall and tightly attached to the dorsal side of the animal. Significance of the loose attachment of the skin. 1. Creates a fluid filled space for dissolution of gases. 2. Allow free distension of the abdomen. B. Describe blood saturation to the skin. Procedure. Loosen the skin from the underlying muscle to turn it back freely. Care must be taken not to cut the musculocutaneous vein under each arm. Observation and significance. The skin is covered by a dense network of capillaries which join up to form main veins that return oxygenated blood towards the heart. This maintains a high diffusion gradient for gaseous exchange. Question 2. Expose and draw superficial thigh muscles on the ventral side of the right hind limb. Note that exposing and drawing muscles on a different limb other than the one specified in the question lead to loss of marks. The muscles include right triceps femoris, right sartorius, right adductor magnus, right gracilis. Note that the prefix right is necessary because there are similar muscles on the left hind limb. A drawing of the superficial thigh muscles on the ventral side of the right hind limb. We label right triceps femoris, right sartorius, right adductor magnus, right gracilis. You may pause and draw. Practice to remember. Question 3. Dissect to expose visceral organs in the chest and the abdominal regions. Draw and label your dissection in undisturbed form. Visceral refers to the internal organs in the great cavities of the body, that is chest and abdomen. Never
Watambula nyumirwa Mwa mwenye azirika Sabasaba, Muba Navato, Buletane Suli, Buletana Magazine, Kusuviza, Kusuviza, Kufuka Mizaba Nene, Kukana Navakazi, Kuyonga Navakuru.
The organ is here referred to in the question A, heart, liver, stomach, duodenum, rectum, urinary bladder, and gallo bladder. A drawing of visceral structures in the chest and abdominal region in undisturbed form. We label heart, liver, stomach, duodenum, gallbladder, and ileum. Question 4, cut along the left lateral line of the mouth to display structures in the buccal cavity. Draw and label the alimentary canal and structures that facilitate digestion of food. This question is similar to question 3, except that this time we are to include structures in the buccal cavity that aid digestion. In the buccal cavity, we consider lips for holding food, tongue for tasting food, and to discriminate bad food from good one. The eyeballs help to push food into the esophagus. Parts of the alimentary canal that are to be included include esophagus, liver lobe, stomach, duodenum, ileum, rectum, parts of the digestive system. A. Esophagus. This is an open tube that delivers food from the buccal cavity to the stomach. Adaptive feature of the esophagus. It is tubular to allow passage of food. It is macicular to enable peristalsis. It is elastic to allow food particles of any size to pass. Stomach. It is a pear-shaped, enlarged part of alimentary canal connected to esophagus and duodenum. Adaptive feature of the stomach. It is macicular to pound food. It is enlarged to store food. Duodenum. This is the first part of intestines. Adaptive feature of the duodenum. It is tubular to allow passage of food. It is connected to the pancreas and the gallbladder to receive digestive secretion. 4. Ilium. It is the portion between the duodenum and the rectum. Adaptive feature of the ilium. It is tubular to allow passage of food. It is long enough to allow time for absorption. 5. Rectum. It is enlarged last part of the alimentary canal. Function and adaptation. It is enlarged to provide temporary storage of feces. Question 5. Make lateral cut to open the buccal cavity. Draw the exposed structures. The structures include upper lip, internal nares, eyeballs, eustachian tube, tongue, and glottis. A drawing of structures in the buccal cavity. We label internal nares, eyeballs, eustachian tube, tongue, and glottis. Blood saturation. When dealing with blood saturation system, note that blood vessels that drain the body are called veins. Blood vessels supply the body are called arteries. When drawing blood vessels, major blood vessels to be bigger than minor blood vessels or branches. Blood vessels must be closed. When required to draw blood vessels, specify the organ. The organs in question should be labeled even if they are not blood vessels. This is to show the association of the organ and the blood vessels in the question. Question 6. Dissect to expose blood vessels that drain the head, left forelimb, and the skin.
We also give you this.
Noise 2.
And this.
Noise 2. These blood vessels include left lingual vein, left mandibular vein, left internal jugular vein, left subscapular vein. This joint form, left innominate vein, left branchial vein, left musculocutaneous vein, joint to form subclavian vein. The external jugular, left innominate vein, left subclavian vein unite to form left anterior vena cava. If the heart is displaced anteriorly, then we are able to see the sinus venosus. A drawing of blood vessels that drain the head, left forelimb, the skin, the heart, displaced anterior. We label left lingual vein, left mandibular vein, left subscapular vein, left branchial vein, left musculocutaneous vein, left innominate vein, left external jugular vein, sinus venosus, anterior vena cava, and the heart. Then we put a magnification. Note that sinus venosus is observable only when the heart is displaced anteriorly. The prefix left is necessary because there are blood vessels of similar names on the right-hand side of the toad. Question 7. Dissect the toad to expose blood vessels that drain the right-hand limb back to the heart displaced anterior. Draw and label your dissection. Let us dissect to expose the required blood vessels. These blood vessels include right femoral vein, right sciatic vein, right pelvic vein, anterior abdominal vein, right renal portal vein. A drawing of blood vessels that drain the right hind limb back to the heart, displaced anterior. We label sinus venosus, posterior vena cava, right renal portal vein, anterior abdominal vein, right pelvic vein, right sciatic vein, and right femoral vein. Question 8. Dissect to display blood vessels that drain the left side of the animal. Trace the route of blood flow from the portal system in this region of your dissection back to the heart. Draw and label. These include blood vessels that drain the left hind limb, such as left femoral vein, left pelvic vein, left sciatic vein, left renal portal vein. Blood vessels that drain the stomach and associated organ include hepatic portal vein, gastric vein, duodenal vein, and intestinal vein. Blood vessels that drain the kidney and the renal vein. Blood vessels that drain left forelimb, the skin, and the heart displaced anterior include left lingual vein, left mandibular vein, left subscapular vein, left branchial vein, left musculocutaneous vein, left innominate vein, left external jugular vein, left subclavian vein, and anterior vena cava.
Yes,
a drawing of blood vessels that drain the left side of the animal and the portal system. We label left pulmonary vein, left lung, hepatic portal vein, gastric vein, intestinal vein, renal vein, left renal portal vein, left pelvic vein, left femoral vein, sinus venosus, posterior vena cava, anterior abdominal vein, left sciatic vein. Then we put a magnification. Question 9. Dissect to expose the main veins of the specimen, the question requires to include on the drawing the veins from the head, lymphs, digestive system, kidney. We have already seen this in the previous question. Actually, this provides a summary of all veins we have so far seen in the toad or a frog. It is advisable to practice the spellings of these names and learn their physical appearance from the animal. Passing exam is one thing, survival is another. Get skills right now. Arterial system. Arteries are blood vessels that carry blood from the heart to the body tissues. A toad or a frog has got distinctive arteries like those that supply the head, left forelimb, and those that supply the stomach and associated organs. Question 10. Dissect to expose blood vessels that supply the left forelimb and left lung. These include laryngeal artery, carotid arc, stomach arc, pulmocutaneous arc, and cutaneous artery. A drawing of blood vessels that supply the left forelimb, the head, and left lung. We label left laryngeal artery, left cutaneous artery, left subclavian artery, left systemic artery, left carotid arc, left systemic arc, left pulmocutaneous arc. The prefix left is necessary because they are similar blood vessels on the right side of the animal. Question 11, expose blood vessels that supply the digestive system and draw. To observe these blood vessels, the stomach should be turned to the right of the animal or to your left. Loosen and remove connective tissues to expose the arteries. The blood vessels include systemic artery, coeliacal mesenteric artery, splenic artery, intestinal artery, coeliacal artery, gastric artery, hepatic artery. A drawing of blood vessels that supply the stomach and associated organ. We label tracheus arteriosus, systemic artery, coeliacal mesenteric artery, mesenteric artery, splenic artery, intestinal artery, coeliacal artery, gastric artery, hepatic artery, and then we put a magnification. Question 12, expose and draw the major arteries of the specimen. The left kidney displaced to the right. This involves structures in the question 10 and 11. We are required to display left laryngeal artery, left carotid labyrinth, left pulmocutaneous arc, left pulmonary artery, left systemic artery, coeliacal mesenteric artery, left renal artery, left iliac artery, left carotid arc, truncus arteriosus, coeliac artery, left gastric artery, hepatic artery, mesenteric artery, intestinal artery, and splenic artery. Usually, question is in examination is are not parallel to a given system, but a mixture of them. What is important is that we get familiar with all the structures of a toad. And before answering the question, is to read, understand, internalize the question. Then you know which structures are required in the question. Adding unnecessary structures to the diagram which are not asked in the question lead to loss of marks.
You asked for something different, and this is our reaction. Reaction, the production.
Yes, we have a song. Yeah. Yes, we have a cacao. Yeah. Yes, we have a ramo. Gambo,
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 gambo, gambo, gambo, gambo,
gambo,
gambo, gambo, gambo, Gamba chirungi, bangesekera ko. Gamba jasanyu, wola.